Hi, I'm Dr. Ilavarasi, Consultant Medical Gastroenterologist, Chennai. So July 28th is announced as the World Hepatitis Day by the WHO. So in this month, I would like to give some awareness about viral hepatitis, especially the chronic viral hepatitis, which is a major public health issue and relatively less known to the public, as well as its equally debilitating disease as HIV. So if you take the global incidence of chronic hepatitis, like hepatitis B and C, it's about 325 million cases are affected globally and 1.4 million deaths are occurring per year. And only 1 in 10 gets tested and only 1 in 5 gets treated. So it's a major health issue and a lot of awareness about this is required. So what is hepatitis? It is the inflammation of the liver. It can be due to various factors, but more commonly it's secondary to viruses. There are many types of viruses, like starting from hepatitis A to hepatitis E, and we also have hepatitis B, C and D. So usually hepatitis A and E are transmitted through water and food, through a contaminated food or water which we take in. And it usually presents with acute symptoms like abdominal pain, jaundice, and usually it settles down with lot of hydration and some oral medications. But we are more concerned today about hepatitis B and C, which is a major public health issue. The main reason to be concerned about this hepatitis B and C is they are totally asymptomatic. They do not cause any symptoms to a person. 80% of the people who are carrying this virus remains asymptomatic. So we need to diagnose this earlier and treat this earlier to prevent chronic liver damage. So now how does this hepatitis B and C spread? Usually it does not spread through food or water like hepatitis A or E. It is through body fluids or somebody shares a syringe or a sharp instrument of an infected person. And it's also sexually transmitted from an infected person. Or it can be vertically transmitted. When a pregnant mother carries hepatitis B or C, it can be transmitted to the child. So this is how hepatitis B and C are transmitted. So now, how do we diagnose this? They are usually diagnosed with some simple blood tests. So once we diagnose, we have a lot of oral medications, very effective medications for hepatitis B to keep the drug, to keep the liver under liver inflammation under control, so that it does not progress on to a advanced chronic liver disease. In fact, for hepatitis C, we have very good medications which can cure the virus in 3 months' time. So now, what are the complications if left untreated? If left untreated, yes, it can lead on to a condition called cirrhosis of liver, where the liver gets shrunken and the patient develops all complications secondary to liver failure, as well as it can also lead on to liver cancer. So now, are there any preventions to prevent this hepatitis B and C? Yes, we have vaccinations for hepatitis B, which can be administered for children as well as for adults. But unfortunately for hepatitis C, we do not have any vaccinations. So now, are there any preventions or precautions which we can take to prevent this hepatitis B and C? Yes, for hepatitis B and A, we have very good vaccinations available. It can be administered for both children as well as for adults. But for hepatitis C, unfortunately, we do not have a vaccination. So basic precautions like do not share syringes for using drugs with other persons, or do not share any handle sharp instruments very carefully, and take lot of precautions while getting tattooing or any body piercing done. So these are the precautions which can be taken. So there might be a question, does a person with hepatitis B or C, can he lead a normal life? Yes, they can lead a very normal life. In fact, if it's detected earlier, they can lead a very, very normal life. Are there any dietary restrictions? Yes, they should not consume alcohol and they can avoid obesity. And if they are a diabetic, their sugar should be under very good control, and they should avoid taking drugs which can injure the liver. So finally, I would like to conclude my talks saying that a lot of awareness about this hepatitis B and C is a major concern, and when diagnosed earlier, it can definitely prevent a lot of deadly complications. So whenever a person is going for a regular health checkup or a master health checkup, or once in a while, they should get themselves screened for this hepatitis B and C. So the key for eliminating hepatitis is getting diagnosed earlier and getting treated earlier. Thank you.